Ask me why I'm crying! It's because of you! That's right, if you do not hit the subscribe button, he is going to use that flamethrower on me.
Please, please hit subscribe. Uh-oh.
What have you done? My entire house is on fire! Please, hit the like button right now to save me. This is way too real. Quick, do it now!
Wow, thanks for hitting the like button, guys.
Also, you suck at Calixo and purchasing Robux, and now, enjoy this video. That's right, a little birdie told me that you guys really liked my last video where I made this. Kinda cute, right? Hello, Piggy! And because you liked it so much, you managed to hit 10,000 likes on that video. And so I said I would do some more. I also asked you guys to comment down below which Piggy character you would like to see. And, well, it looks like you guys were pretty clear on what you wanted. That's right. As you guys can see right now, everybody wants to see Torture Piggy. A couple others were Crove, Sand Piggy, Bacon, and yeah, a ton. More. That really is a lot. And so I've picked three of your suggestions. So shout out to Michael. Shout outs to you, Marcus. And also shout outs to you, Lakshmi. I really hope I got your name right. If you guys want to see me do any more of these designs, put your comment in the comment section down below for a shout out. Okay, so the first one that I'm actually going to go for right now is Crove, which is literally this character right here. And I have to be honest, I think this is going to be one of my hardest ones. So let's do it. So first things first, let's find us self-address. There we go. That is perfect. Now let's just cut it out. And here we go. Just like that. That is awesome. Okay, so what I need to do now is reshape this dress. Yep. There we go. What a beautiful dress. The next thing we need to do is find ourselves some legs and arms. And obviously, this is a crow. I'm just realizing this is going to be really, really hard. Okay, and I think I found my legs, ladies and gentlemen, right here. So, yep, let's cut these out as well and get these put in position. Okay, and just like that, our foot has been cut out. So let's put it behind the dress, just like that. And let's try and get the sizing right on it. You can see there's a bit of fat just coming out under here. So something like that is actually going to be perfect. Yes, yes it is. Okay, so far this is actually what we're working with. It looks really weird and disgusting, but it is going to look better. Okay, so here we go. This is the next thing I need, and that is the arm, ladies and gentlemen, aka a wing in this case, because I don't know if you guys know this or not, but crows actually have wings instead of arms. Yes, you heard it here first, ladies and gentlemen, and I have to put this on this character without it looking all weird and make it look like a hand somehow. So yes, this is gonna be difficult. Oh my goodness, why does it look so bad? Seriously, this is literally gonna be the hardest thing to make look like an arm, because obviously you guys know that Crowy has these really cool arms and I am literally giving them wings. Yes, I am. How's about that then, huh? That's what I thought. Pretty, pretty good if you ask me. Okay, again, so far, this is what we're working with. It's not finished. It is time to add the scythe. Okay, maybe something like this, and hopefully, not bad. Not bad at all. That looks quite good, guys. Okay, so the next thing we need to do is get ourselves the hood for the avatar, and that's gonna be really easy. Looking pretty good, Buster. Yep, so let's just adjust this a little bit. I want to change the color first of all because I'm not happy with it, and after I change the color to match the dress that we have on, something like this, I also want to do a couple more adjustments. One is add some curves to make it a little bit darker on the bottom, just like that. And the second is to come to the warp selection because I think this is slightly too big. I don't know which one to pick. This is so hard. I just feel like this one is actually a little bit more like it, even though this one probably looks better up here. Okay, you know what? I think I'm going with this one here. It turns out this picture is useful after all. Okay, so let's just put that roughly where the eye is, like this. And then we're gonna put the other one on the other side, roughly like this as well. I will play about with these in a second, but for a minute, that is good enough. Okay, this is starting to look kind of good, guys. Now we just need to change the color of our eyes. This one is actually glowing and the other one is not. So this one needs to be black.
Okay, and there we go. We now have a glowing eye like that, which I think I'm actually just gonna move across a little bit. Now it is time to start adding everything together, putting shading on and making it pop, which will look something just like this. And ladies and gentlemen, there we have it. That is Crowy. Oh yeah, Crowy is actually looking pretty terrifying. Next is Parasy. And again, I'm sure a lot of you know who Parasy is. He's one of my favorites. He's like an alien version of Piggy. So this is Parasy, and this is the guy that we're gonna be making any second now. So I think I'm actually gonna start with the head this time. And to create it, I'm going to use this. Yep, an alien. He's kind of cute, weird looking, smelly. Okay, and now we have a head. We need to make some adjustments, including, like I've already done, removing the eyes. Now it is time for me to also remove the nose and the mouth, ladies and gentlemen, because I don't want to hear this alien speak unless he's telling you to use Starco Calixo. Okay? Okay, next, we want to change the color of this because it's the wrong color to a red E color. Something a bit like this. Okay, and something like this. I think I should bring this to the front and merge it in. I think that's gonna look so much better. Next up, we need a piggy nose. This one is perfect because this one is mine. Okay, and I think this is looking pretty good. There we go. Next up, it's time for us to add ourselves a body. Okay, and leg one like that, and leg two. I could put the same way, but I think it might look a bit weird, so I'm gonna put it that way. Does that look weird? I can't tell. Yeah, it looks kind of weird, but I actually kind of like it. Yeah. Okay, next up, we need to do the arms and the tentacles, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, it is tentacle time, so let's get these tentacles out, ladies and gentlemen, and let's start getting them on our body. So I actually kind of like the idea of this one being in the background like that, and maybe using it again on a bottom corner, maybe down here somewhere like this. Just like this. And now we're gonna use this one up here. Maybe like that, and then also down over on the bottom side, just like this. Okay, and I think the colorization has been done, so now what I need to do, ladies and gentlemen, is get myself some shading going on. This is definitely gonna take a really long time. Okay, guys, we are almost done. I'm literally just adding the last final few shadows, and once I've done it, I can finally put a background to this image. So all I need to do now is add a shadow to the neck, because everybody has a neck shadow, and this guy doesn't. So let's give him a little neck shadow like that. Just turn it down a little bit like this. Okay, next, what we need to do is simply add a background to our image, and ladies and gentlemen, we are done with Parasy. Okay, well, there's probably so much more I could do to this, but guys, I think I'm finished. This is my idea of what Parasy would look like, though I'm sure I could do a ton more. I'm pretty happy with how this turned out. Now, it is time for the third and final creation of the day, which is my personal favorite, and that is Torture. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, this is Torture. We all love him, I guess. But I really, really want this to look good, so I'm gonna make sure that I put as much time in as I can, even though I've already spent 2 hours and 15 minutes doing this. Oh my goodness. Pretty good. When I set out to do this, I didn't set out to do it halfway. I set out to do it properly, and you deserve that. I know. It looks so much better. So next, I'm going to add this little circle thing here as my nose piece, because I want it, again, just to be as realistic as possible. Okay, that is actually looking pretty good. Okay, next up, it is time for us to start adding our body. As you can see, he has like a weird... I don't even know what you call this body. What is it? Okay, so we actually found a real life version of what this suit is supposed to be, but it doesn't look exactly like we need it. I have a lot of work to do. Okay, let's merge that down. And now what I actually want to do is I want to cut this out and get rid of this arm right here. Okay, and now we have our body. It's time to angle this in the correct place. So let's get that behind our head like this. And let's make it a lot smaller till it's about here. Next, I'm gonna add the legs before I do anything else with this body, because otherwise I'm gonna get too far ahead of myself. Make it wider, change the angle a bit, and let's drop these legs underneath our body just like this. What I need to focus on now before I do anything else is the flamethrower, because the flamethrower needs to be in the right place for everything else to match up. Okay, this one might actually work. If I take the color away and make it gray like Torches, it might not be that recognizable. And then we just go like this to remove the horrible edges. Finally, it looks like theirs is a little more gray than ours, so I want to take away some of these curves. I also just noticed the bottom of the legs is entirely gray, just like this. Whoop! Okay, let's put these boots on underneath and see what they look like. I hope they don't look bad. Okay, they don't look too bad at all. What if I twist this to go this direction? Then I get a copy of the thumb like this, which might I also note needs to be black, and I put it like this. Is that gonna look bad? Okay, it doesn't actually look too bad. You can tell the hands coming through there. That actually looks quite good. In fact, I believe in that so much, I could probably just add my fingers literally like this. Wait a minute, wait a minute. I think I found it. That's right, something like that. I really just want to change this shoulder because it's way too big. Okay, now this is roughly what we're looking at so far. I have a lot of work to do. Especially with the shoulder. This is not good. Okay, okay, not looking too bad. Now what I want to do is start adding some fire. And that starts with an epic background. Something like this. Then what I need to do is add some fire coming out of my flamethrower. Now I've added my fire, I really want to add my reflection. So for this, I could probably literally go like this and drag this down. This will be my first reflection, aka my water reflection. Something like that. Next, I need to add my general blur to the bottom, which is a bit like that. Then we need to add our smoke, which I'm actually gonna change the color of to make it more orange, just like this. And we're gonna stick this on the very front of our image. Okay, next what I wanna do, like I said, is add highlights to all of this image. So I'm gonna copy as much of it as I can from here. And at the minute, it doesn't look very good, but what I need to do next is start pushing these about. Something a bit like this. Now hopefully when I click overlay, it adds a beautiful orange glow. As you guys can see, when I take it off and put it back on, it just makes the fire look more realistic. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, there we have it. That is Torture Piggy. And that one took an hour and a half. If you haven't hit subscribe already, what are you waiting for? This is taking so long. Let me know in the comment section who you want me to do next time in the next video, and I will shout you out as per usual. Again, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next video. Goodbye!